Tigrane sur Pure Channel. Thank you very much, Tigrane, for coming on Pure Channel. It's a pleasure. My first question, as all the interviews here, is of course, you must be very excited to play in Montréal with your band, Arata Rebirth. What did you prepare? Did you have special things for the gig tonight?
We're gonna play mostly the music from my previous record called Arata Red Hail, and some new songs that the Montreal audience is gonna hear for the first time.
Okay, the question, when I read your biography, of course I was struck by the age you were interested in the instrument, the piano. And I wonder, was it a vocation really, a need you had even when you were 2 or 3 years old, or something that your family bring naturally and the surrounding bring to you?
Well, yeah, there was a lot of music in my family at my home, you know, when I was growing up, since 2 years old, and others. My father was listening to a lot of classic rock, and my uncle was listening to a lot of jazz, and my grandparents had this huge collection of classical music, you know, like classical vinyls. So it was just so much music in the house.
As a young boy, what gave you the need to go on the piano? The sound?
There was, you know, like, there was. We had 2 pianos in my grandmother's place and in my parents' place, so there was an instrument in the house. So you know, it was almost. I'm very, very lucky that we had a piano. You know, and, that kind of made things a little easier. And I would just go try to pick up songs from what I've heard. You know, playing like Led Zeppelin songs and playing like some Black Sabbath songs. You know.
Very young, you started with Deep Purple, Led Zeppelin.
Yeah, I loved that stuff, you know, it was a huge, huge part of my life at that time.
Is it what brings you the joy again to play? Having the sensation you are in a universe and language?
Yeah. Of course, I mean, just music itself is very... It's a language that either you speak or you don't speak, you know. There's no jazz, there's no rock, there's no, you know, if the energy, I mean, I love every kind of music, you know. If I hear music, a sound that I like, you know, I love it. If not, then not.
You moved to New York, and is that right? You live now in New York?
Yes, I did.
A lot of musicians says they are stunned by the energy of the city, but also, and that's what we were talking about, but the fact that jazz is really mixed to other genres, to hip-hop, to electro, in the new blue, to stuff like that. Did you had a new step in your way of working, composing your music when you arrived in that city?
I've definitely heard a lot of things that I've never heard before when I arrived to New York. You know, like you said, like the electronica thing, kind of the new hipster New York stuff. I love it, you know. I mean, everything, like I said, everything influences me, you know. But New York, some amazing musicians there, you know, from different worlds of music, you know. It's electronica, jazz, rock. You know.
Is there a crew for you that you need now to play and to go wild on the gig? You need these guys.
These guys are absolutely non-changeable guys. You know, they're crucial members of the band. The band is. If you take out any of the band members, the band doesn't exist. You know, it's really, really a special band.
That's a bit like a rock band, let's say.
Yeah. I mean, special musicians, you know, musicians that can understand my music, and in the best way I can possibly imagine, you know, and at the same time bring their own thing, you know, but in a way that. It takes whatever I imagined to another level, you know, it's like the higher level. Yeah, of course. It's all about surprising me, but in a specific way. You know, it's not. They don't. Nate, or my drummer, knows exactly. I mean, he doesn't. He surprises me every time, but it never surprises me in a way where I was like, oh, that wasn't that musical. Nate is one of the most musical drummers in the world, you know. He never everything he plays is he never plays anything that's goes against the music, you know, or something choppy or something, you know.
Kosi on stage, of course, if you have the occasion, Chigwin and the band Arata Rebirth, and of course the records you can buy legally on every platform. Thank you very much, Chigwin. It's a pleasure.
You.
Thanks.
Pleasure too.